worry about that shit. Come on, that shit.
This show brought you by Stark Enterprises, nigga.
What you want, nigga? Everything, nigga, supersize. Super
for real, nigga.
Like when they doing them 2 for 5.
In the post podcast every Saturday, my G.
In the drive through in the black.
Believe it. Believe it.
Two with the max sauce. I sold hard and I had sauce. Before Bow Wow with Shad Moore.
Man, this shit legal.
I'm just letting these facts show. I was getting them packs off for my Air Force, the Task Force, and the CIA, and DEA, and TNT.
Y'all know what type of vibe I'm on right now. That's it.
For the Jacka boy, for the Hot Pie boys in the red band.
That's it.
Yes, man.
$1 million
on my left hand. Threatening me, you a dead man. Time for some action, red man.
It's only money. That's it, man.
I said it's only money.
It's only a couple dollars, nigga.
It's
only a couple dollars, nigga.
Yeah, it's only money. It's only money, yo.
Alright. Shout out to Artika Tierra and Melanie Rain. I did it day, like the other day. We're gonna talk about this shit in a second. You know what I'm saying? We're gonna talk about this shit a little minute. We're gonna talk some sports shit too today. You know what I'm saying?
Plus size, but they still want me to ride it.
Yeah.
Get on top, watch his little stick slide in.
Yeah.
Got them all in his feelings, no pun. His intended trying to wanna ride me full of ass dive in. Wet shit,
we got a lot of you feel. Talk about like that, man. Talk about
like that. Work down, daddy looking like a candlestick. Climb off, cause you know I gotta take a lick. Wrap my tongue around it, I'm about to go off. Deep throat, like you know I'm a show off. Push you down, hang your ass, come in no time. Round two, you better break it over my spine.
Like, share, comment. Subscribe in the post podcast every Saturday, motherfucker. You feel me? You feel me?
Got you backstroke. Bet them niggas know your name because them hoes know. Man, I don't know show. I'ma talk my shit while you in it. Might make you tap out right before you finish. Say your grace while you eating because we sinning. Give you a trophy when you done because you winning. Boy, you got me swimming in my ocean in the deep. Treading me so hard.
This song called Swimming. I know y'all hip, man. Swimming on all streaming platforms. Our ticket to year, Melody Rain. What's good with you? Low key and no gin. One thing for sure, two things for certain, though. Niggas gotta keep it real. I stay on real shit. I can't be on fuck shit out here. You feel me? Straight up. Let's go.
Deep throat, daddy, I know how you like it. Ass fat, baby, go ahead, bite it. The way you looking at me, baby, it's enticing. Come here, daddy, and let little mama ride it. Well, like a jacuzzi, he bust like a Uzi. He all on my body, I'm feeling that. He got me excited, I told him to slide in. I promised this boy you will not forget.
I'm smoking some trees, you down on your knees.
You trying to send me straight to heaven, babe. Bend over, don't stop, he pounded me out. Stood up on my toes. Me and you, boy, that's a hella mate. You just swallowed a pussy like you ain't ate. I'ma fuck you real good, I won't hesitate. Now you about to reach your climax. Never had clapback, slap that. I ain't arched this shit for nothing. You talking that shit, but do not get to running. Make sure I'm coming. Dick so good, I'ma have to call a friend. Goddamn, I'ma have to spin the block again. Artika Tierra and Melody Rain. Yeah, you know the vibe when we tapping in.
Yo, you already know what it is. Another Saturday in the building. It's your boy GAM, Hollywood Shop.
We outside.
We outside. We back at the normal headquarters and shit. Now, first things first, I want to shout out Melody Rain and Artika Tierra for real. At the end of the day, this is a deeper, valuable lesson that I just want niggas to understand, right? It ain't their fault that they're not here today. It's not their fault at all. To be honest, it's ours.
Yeah.
You feel me?
Too much.
And that goes to show for niggas, like, bro, like, chill, kill that shit. Nigga, kill that shit. Perfect your craft, bro. You can't be jumping out the window, bro. It ain't no time for jumping out the window out here. Niggas really trying to make some plays and make shit happen. And it's consistency that's going to make that happen. You feel me? Like, Dame had a little play on a little, on the motherfucking Glenville Fest. You know, they just up the street. We right here on 95th up the street. They, you know what I'm saying, just named 99th after Bone and shit yesterday. You feel me? So we trying to celebrate, you know what I'm saying, the 50 years of hip-hop as well. That's some shit that we should have just put in the air a little bit earlier than just, you know what I'm saying, yesterday type shit. So Interpol's got to take that on the chin. You feel me? And moving forward for y'all artists and shit, y'all take heed. Don't be jumping out the window, man. Playing your shit out. You know what I'm saying? Put your ducks in a row, my G. You feel me? Straight up and down. They're going to be on the show next week, though. Most definitely. We're going to have Artie Gutierrez and Melanie Rand on the show next week. Next week, we're going to have Artie Gutierrez and Melanie Rand on the show. This was our fault. And we're going to have to take this on the chin. You feel me? Ro the Prince and Duck, we're going to get with y'all because we're going to have to figure something out. Because I don't know about just pushing everything back a week, because at the end of the day, we got some shit going on the 26th that I feel like we going to make that happen. So with that being said, yeah, that's all I really got to say about this shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, I maybe on the IG, maybe y'all ain't really here all the way. You know what I'm saying? Shit been going kind of crazy today. Like, I ain't going to fake. Like, shit been kind of crazy. I've been trying to keep it cool because it's like, there's no need to go crazy when shit get crazy. You feel what I'm saying? At the end of the day, somebody got to be the cooler head. Somebody got to be able to be there to be like, all right, boom, we did this wrong, but we could fix it like this. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. At the end of the day, game ain't over, my nigga. We still in the second quarter. Ain't even halftime yet. You feel me? Straight up.
As Chase said, I'm going to reiterate, it was not their fault that they're not here. It is our fault. You know what I'm saying? Trying to do too much. It really wasn't too much, but the rain situation, you know what I'm saying, Cleveland's weather, do whatever the fuck it want to.
Yeah.
It wasn't supposed to rain until later on in the day, but when we were setting up, it went from sunny to we heard crackling and electrical equipment and lightning outside ain't a good look.
No, it's definitely not. It's definitely not a good look. So at the end of the day, like, we apologize to them. And we got y'all. Trust and believe.
We got y'all. Trust y'all.
We got y'all. Trust and believe. 26 August. Tooth and Bread presents Kings and Queens. You know what I'm saying? Battle of the Sexes show. We will be live streaming in that joint. You feel me?
We will be in the building.
And you know your boy is going to be a judge too. So y'all come with y'all shit on gang. You feel me? On gang. So we, you know how we start a show. So how was your week and shit, pimp?
It's semi-productive. Not as productive as I wanted to. You know, you see the couple filters. I got to figure out the algorithm of the ones that they not accepting and the ones that they do accept. Because it's about 10 of them that they just ain't accepted. And I don't know what to... Some of them, I thought maybe it was a little too provocative, but some of them they let go. So I was like, the ones that didn't, what's the glitch? You know what I'm saying? I did remake the Tooth the Brand.
You got the joint ready for the Battle of Sexes.
And that loaded. I just tweaked it a little bit. Didn't do much changing, and it loaded.
Between because she said the pick too. Shout out to Tooth the Brand. Hit Tooth the Brand on Friday. She, you know, said she came through. Shout out to everybody who, you know what I'm saying, who replied. We hit up too. Most definitely. This is one of the days where it's just like it's just everything just thrown off a little bit. But it's cool, though. And the only reason why it's cool is because, shit, nigga, get the smoke, man. Nigga, we're smoking past couple months, man. Ooh. In this spot, man. Shout out to Ray Shark, man, for putting us together with the spot of shit.
We
definitely going to be back in the building next week. That's where we going to be. That's where we should have just went ahead and just went to that show. But my nigga had some shit going on, too, family shit. So I kind of try to give my nigga some reprieve and shit.
Yeah.
But it is what it is. We ain't been talking about those sports in the business.
I mean, it ain't really been no real
news. So shit, the motherfucking Browns played downtown last night, man, nigga.
Like I said, it ain't been no real news, nigga.
Hey, but the little third stringer though, the DTR cat. DTR got some work, bro. He all right. Browns defense is looking good too right now. I'll give them that too. Their defense is on point a little
bit. Defense was doing what it was doing, but we probably might have got caught in the, you know what I'm saying, the Cleveland curse.
What you trying to imply?
Jacoby Brissett.
He ain't did shit. He threw a pick. He ain't did shit.
He won a game here.
He ain't did shit.
They would.
Man,
almost all the bullshit. People who leave Cleveland come back.
That's some bullshit because the nigga, K. York missed the motherfucking field goal in the fourth quarter, nigga. Come on, man. Nigga K. York missed the field goal. That's all the reason why they lost.
Does it qualify defending that curse?
No.
These niggas who leave Cleveland come back and win their game when they come back. Their first game. Most of them. Almost all of them.
Damn. Let me ask you a question. This is a real question. How can it be a curse and it's the motherfucking preseason? Can you answer me that?
Okay.
I barely even watched the preseason, bro. I just watched it. It ain't shit on TV, so fuck
it. That was terrible.
And plus, on top of that, the shit was like, wait, delayed for about 2 hours because of the rain.
Yes, it was.
Like, bro, like, come on, it's the fucking preseason. Like, it's cool, like, for football fans who, you know what I'm saying, like, y'all don't like watching football. That's just like, you feel me, the NBA or MLB, whoever watched that shit preseason. I know nobody watched that shit preseason. But anyway, it's the preseason, man. It ain't really shit, for real. But you gonna see what second to third string is gonna probably make the team. DTR should be on the team.
Yeah.
DTR should be on the team for a shit show. And Dobbs, Dobbs is doing what we did today. Dobbs be doing too much. He good, but he be doing too much. You gotta chill, bro. Don't be a Baker Mayfield, bro. And furthermore, nigga, I already talked about Parker, man, before we went live. We will not be posting no more Baker Mayfield shit again on our shit. What's wrong with him? I seen that shit last night. I really was about to be petty and delete that shit on gang, but I was like, you know what? I ain't even gonna do my nigga like that. I'm gonna let that shit sit. Yeah.
I would've went and found some shit, nigga.
Shit, alright, bet. Alright, team good.
So, we not talking about that no more. We still talking sports, because really, unless Dame trade happened.
Yeah, I mean, but we still can talk a little something. I just motherfucking hit her up and shit. We probably gonna be, like I'm saying, 19th Artika Tier and Melanie Rand gonna be on the show. We should just stick to the script, but.
Yeah.
Yeah, man, Pip, like, on some real shit, Pip. You gotta trust me, Pip. I've been here before, Pip. In different circumstances, though. You feel me? We doing a podcast, we try to reach the masses with this podcast. You feel me?
Look, I know that, but besides all that, you know, in the words of my nigga Big Jesus, you know I do the most.
It's got to be concentrated, my G. Like, anybody can do the most. No disrespect to my boy Big Jesus, because he do the most in a concentrated atmosphere. His shit calculated. He know what he doing. You feel me? Like, his shit calculated, my nigga. So, niggas can do the most, but that shit gotta be calculated. You can't just be out here willy-nilly, my G. What type of progression is that? There ain't no progression out here, my G. Like, just people, like, we're like, we're progressing. Like, people's been going on. Like, nigga, this is probably, like, you know what I'm saying? This is really one of the first shows we had last week. We thought it was gonna be like this, but my boy pulled up. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Top Shadow Rule Boy. Real nigga. Real nigga though. I fuck with dude. Yeah. Like, real cat. Like, you know what I'm saying? Genuine guy. I fuck with him. He got nice music. Go stream his music. You know what I'm saying? Straight up. But it's like, okay, we got that off. I prepared to talk to them too today. You feel me? If I knew it was gonna be a situation like this, I would have some sports shit, because it's some sports shit to talk about. Trust me. It's some little shit to talk about. Some little provocative shit. Nothing that we want to stay on too long. But it's some little funny shit to talk about. It definitely is. But yeah, man, it's about being concentrated and calculated. That move to the office and shit was a calculated move. I was breaking that move down since February, man. You feel me? And just luckily, through the grace of God, he threw something in my lap. that I could take advantage of that could be that was right along what I wanted in my vision, though. You feel what I'm saying? Yeah. So it's like niggas gotta follow that vision, my G. Like, it's gonna be a lot of shit that's gonna be out here to derail niggas. It's gonna be a lot of flashy shit out here, bro, that's gonna make you think, ooh shit, I want, ooh shit. But bro, that shit can go away in a second, my nigga. In a second. It's all about the work niggas put in, the concrete work, bro. It ain't about that little flashy shit, bro. We can do that shit. Or the calculated level, and it could be the biggest shit ever. Like before, we've been calculating some shit, man. So the motherfucking, what's that, the 10th? September 10th? Muni lot.
We in the Muni lot.
It's in the building, for sure. Muni lot is in the building. Hey, you know what I'm saying? Fuck with us in the Muni lot, man. We're going to be right next to Spurs and Moore. You know what I'm saying? Fuck with us. You know what it is. A lot of y'all just seen the daughter before. Y'all know what it is. Fuck with us. You already know. So let's get into this real quick. So, because you went to the invalid of the street name yesterday.
Yeah.
How was that? How was the vibes of that, man? Talk to me about who you linked up with, who you talked to.
Let's start before.
Shit like that.
Okay, you sent me the flyer and said it started noon.
Yeah.
Dame Dirty and TC got something that said it started too.
Okay.
So, I went to the first one, and they went to the second one, which I didn't know it was no second one. After they left from over here, I guess they bent back around the corner and they was doing whatever they was doing.
Yeah. Because I heard it was out there. A lot of people got pictures. I guess they got pictures after the two draw.
Yeah.
I thought you would have had some pictures of shit, but you was at the crib at that point, huh?
Because I left out of there at about like 3 o'clock, almost 4. Yeah. So, I'm saying.
So, what time that shit was really over there? Like 5, 6, some shit like that?
Yeah, I mean,
which was probably cool. It was like they had the whole little shit.
Yeah, when I left, it was like a handful of people that was still out there. It wasn't a crowd. It was maybe only about like 15, 20 people. But I was like, whatever. And so when I dipped off, it was still people out there, but your boy was breaking down. You know what I'm saying? So I was like, well, I guess this is over.
Shout out to this slapper too, man. But you feel me? Like, shout out to this slapper too, just on the side note. Shout out to this slapper. Shout out to my nigga Keontae. Hey, man, on game. This nigga be doing this shit right there at the G-Spot, detail spot right there on Hayden. Every Tuesday, he up there. Man, I be trying to get up to that motherfucker, man. It's like he up there from 2 to 4. I don't get off till 5, 6. I got to pull up on this nigga, man. In a minute, man, I'm going to have to pay for this nigga to cater some shit just so I can ask him the shit. I swear to God. Because for what I've been hearing, that shit been slapping in the punch, though. I know that I hear the little juice, the slapping juice,
man,
shit.
Man, that punch shit is diabetes in the cup.
That shit slapping.
Whoa!
Bro, that shit slapping. That shit slapping right in the face. That shit slapping, bro. Shout out my nigga Keontae, man. That shit slapping. For shit show.
No, so basically I saw it looked like it was wearing it down. So I guess, but you know how it is. That people, with 15 people still standing out there, other people pulled up. Then there was 25 people, and then other people pulled up. Now you probably got about 35 people, which is going to make whoever thought something was going to happen.
But I heard it was a lot of people in and out that motherfucker. It was a lot of people over there. Right here. It was a lot of people out there.
You know, you can see the spot from the corner of the street, right?
Yeah.
All that spot that you could see right there was filled with people.
Right.
It was people everywhere. And every spot, possible standing spot, you could see down that bitch. There was people standing there. Oh, now back to who did I run into? I ran into some of everybody.
Was it talk to me?
I ran into the Ohio player.
Oh, you talking about Mookie Batiato?
Yeah, Mookie
Batiato.
Shout
out my nigga Mook, man.
You know what I'm saying?
Shout out my nigga Mook, man. I know that nigga for a minute. That's my guy.
You know what I'm saying?
That's my motherfucking guy.
I keep, you know what I'm saying, be out here shooting the gift. Like I'm introducing this shit to niggas.
Yeah.
But I know who the fuck y'all is off the jump. Nigga went, you know what I'm saying? He want to get his bid on, so I tell him we get later on.
Oh, we gonna fuck with him.
Yeah, of course.
We gonna fuck with him, man.
I already let him know sports season is gonna be on and popping, so.
He gonna talk some sports shit?
He better be on his one, too.
But he gonna talk some sports shit, though. I know he is. Like, that nigga man ain't gonna play around.
I ran into King Jammer, formerly Soulja Boy. I ran into MC Brains. I ran into, I can't remember her name, but she was a vocalist with Bone when they first started rapping.
You talking about motherfucker off the girl off the Thuggish Ruggish Bone? That's who you talking about?
No, she said she was with them before they met Izzy.
So what song was she on? So it wasn't Tasha?
No, she tried. She was It was too much going on. She was trying to show me, but she on one of the, feeds. I seen Ken Dog. It was just a whole lot of people outside.
You was up there with the girl Lady T, shout out Lady T, yeah, and shit.
Lady T. She seemed to be in a lot of places that we be trying to go outside of the music scene. You know what I'm saying? She be in the, like, we trying to be more social and events that had to do with the community.
Just more so in the community, yeah. Really. That's really what the aim is.
And she, you know what I'm saying, she is into that.
Okay, well, we probably tap in with her. You know what I'm saying? Anything else you want to say about that shit? Because I was at work, though. I did watch the feed a little bit, but.
DJ Izzo, you know what I'm saying, who collaborates with Welcome to the BBW Show.
Shout out to Stacy.
And Miss Reese, he they engineer.
Yeah.
We good. So he said he want to see what's up when we down at the tailgate.
Shit, tell him pull up on us at the meeting lot, my G. Let's turn up, man.
And then on some more, it was a monumental thing, but what made it a little more monumental, I told you about the incident in Devin and the dude who's around the corner.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I saw him. I gave him, you know what I'm saying? I gave him OG status. That's some shit OGs do. You know what I'm saying? He, I was going to pop my top. He stopped it. On some player type shit. I saw him and he was like, yeah, of course, nigga, I remember your son right there.
Yeah.
That's some real shit. That's the type of love I want In the Post to have from the cats in the street. And this ain't had nothing to do with In the Post. It's just on some, he know me.
Yeah.
No, he met me. He seen me. Right.
Okay, that's bad.
Now, we chopped it up. So now, he know me. But, who was it? The Trill North.
I know what you're talking about.
They was there.
Yeah.
The puppet cat. Low,
The seed. Low, I know what you're talking about. As this stuff, like SW, some shit. I know what you're talking about, bro.
That is a funny little nigga.
That nigga tried to do his little thing, man. Yeah. I ain't gonna hold you.
He doing his thing.
I mean, in the day, it's a lame, man. That peanut line 215 shit ain't popping like it used to be, man. Like, even though they tried to get that shit back popping, that shit with the shit was popping. Shout out to Peanut Line 205. That's where they all get that shit from. That shit was funny as fuck. Yeah. If y'all niggas to come with that type vibe, nigga, we fucking with you. Shit.
Yeah.
All right, so that was cool. Shout out to Bone, you know what I'm saying? Right up the street. So, shit, the Browns did they thing. You see this nigga Donovan Mitchell playing 101 against the nigga Cole Anthony from the motherfucking Orlando Magic.
No, I did not.
Came up, hit him with an in out, step back, crossover that nigga. Gee! I'm like, damn. And you know who was and that nigga, and they had the nigga, and they got the little son, Mello's son was giving him work too.
So,
Mello's son was doing his thing.
On that note, what about, what's the name of son? Like, he ain't gonna be the play no more then.
No, I ain't heard that like that. Like, at this point, we're just giving it a wait and see approach. You know what I'm saying? Like, we've been, you know what I'm saying, doing our little thing these past couple of months. We've been having a lot of these artists come through and chop it up. So we haven't really discussed the Bronny James situation. And I'm kind of glad, because I don't want to speculate about a young kid like that.
Yeah.
Like, he's still a young kid. He's still trying to do his thing. I don't care if his dad LeBron James. Honestly. Yeah,
more importantly, who the fuck he is. That's who we got to be.
Yeah, like, I don't care if his dad LeBron James. But at the end of the day, it's like, he got to get the proper care he need. If we gotta set out more power to it, more, you know what I'm saying? Whatever. Like, this hope the best for him, Bryce, you know what I'm saying, Zari, whatever, Savannah, and Brian. Best for their whole family. You feel me?
Yeah.
I ain't gonna speculate. Like, we don't get paid to speculate. And even if they pay me, I ain't speculating, my boy. Like, stop it.
I don't know.
No, I ain't speculating on nothing.
I speculate on sports.
I don't even want to speculate on sports. Sometimes niggas be sounding so dumb when they speculate. That's what people do on the internet all the time. Speculate on sports. Sometimes these people sound dumb.
I mean, I was speculating when I started knowing Kyle Kuzma's name.
That's not no speculation. How's that speculation? You're just saying like he looked like the eye test say that he got a little game. How's that speculating? You ain't said that nigga's about to be the MVP of the league, nigga. That still ain't even speculating. That's still even speculating. What's speculating is like saying like you think that Megan Thee Stallion and Ben Simmons fucked or something, Pauls. Like that's speculating. That's what speculating is.
Yeah.
That's the type like rumors shit. Speculation is like a rumor. Like, how can you like sports ain't no real rumor? It's kind of dry. It's number based.
Yeah, it is what it is. The numbers show the footage.
Yeah, the number and the eye test. It ain't about shit else. It's about your numbers and the eye test. These niggas that give 30 a night, they look like they should get 30 a night. They look the part, like bro, like come on. They look like it. Like shit. So shit. What up, man? We got some. I'm trying to figure out how we talk a little more shit. Cause I don't know. That's what I'm saying. Like. Niggas was planning to talk to them and shit. Like, I already got shit. You feel me? I already got shit. I mean, I don't know. Niggas ain't talking about that Guardian shit because that shit wasn't worth shit. That nigga hit that nigga clean with the right. It's like, shit, it's over. What we discussing?
Well, when I watched baseball, it was a lot more of that going on. So that really ain't. It ain't really that.
I mean, shit. I ain't gonna say it ain't that deep, but I'm just saying, like, at the end of the day, them niggas ain't really with it. Like, Guardians ain't about to do shit in the playoffs, no disrespect.
I ain't talking about that. I'm talking about the fights. In the 90s, the fights used to go hard. The whole team would be fighting. You hit anybody on this team, you gotta hit everybody in this bitch.
Yeah.
So, that wasn't no. It was a little chin shot, that's all. That was a little chin shot. Who would expect him to have a box of shit? He played baseball.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's that shit right there.
Yeah, but at the end of the day, bro, niggas just had to really pop up here, pop out, lightweight. Sarah would too, give our piece of shit. Our ticket to year, Melody Ray. Hopefully, we had them come on next week. 9 times out of 10, that's what's gonna happen on the 19th. Yeah. 26, Styler McAmilly. It's with. We gotta stay on course and shit. I don't know, real rap. Sometime within this week, I'm gonna try to figure out, not this week coming up, but probably next week, we're gonna probably have an opening during the week where we will record and then post it on our YouTube, Facebook. You know what I'm saying? Spotify posted on all those pages. Patreon, too. Our Patreon. We're about to start getting this Patreon popping. So yeah, tap in with that. You feel me? Like, so and we can really get niggas in. Get niggas in told.
That starts. That means you can come get your pictures for your filters. You can come get your information that you want to be put on. You want a filter. One filter is going to be $35. I have a special filter for 50, which is you tap and switch to find the filter that you want. It will contain 5. I need 5 photos or 5 images. I need your logo, I need your information, I need your stuff and your color scheme. And
that's a deal, man. $50, get your shit together. 35, get your one plane.
35 is the event you throwing or, cause who want the one?
Yeah, I might as well just get that 50 block.
Right.
Yeah, so with that being said, man, before this shit get to going crazy, get with y'all niggas next week, little quick little in and out situation. Y'all keep liking, sharing, commenting, keep fucking in the post podcast. We're gonna keep fucking with y'all. We're gonna keep giving y'all what y'all want. That's that real shit. You feel? Straight like that.
Pay attention, cause when we in the building, it's gonna be lit. Oh, I know for sure. I'm a little more reserved. You know what I'm saying, on the show. Oh, but when I'm in the building, it's gonna be lit. Thing.
So y'all know what it is, man. We don't got no outro, nigga. So, see y'all next week, man.
It's 178. Hold on.